Bavarian dialect, they use older words, which are kind of really apparently hip to use. But you know, like old German, or, you know, even in Norway, the IKEA catalog, all those names, that's old Swedish. IKEA never has to make a catalog for every country in the world. They use old Swedish, and your thing's called the Obosk, or something, and it's called that to every language in the world. So these guys sing in that kind of thing in a Bavarian language. So here is, and I don't even know what they're saying. Here is "You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet," sung in Bavarian by the Spider Murphy Gang. By Luther Gang with Gelduska Daska Ding, translated to "You Ain't Seen Nothing Yet." We're going to stay in Germany. Here's a song written by Fred Wise, Ben Wiseman, Kay Towney, and Bert Camford. You know Bert Camford, he played the flugelhorn, had a big hit called "Wonderland by Night." That's when instrumentals were big on the radio back in the 60s. And I've always been an Elvis fan. Elvis made me switch from playing classical violin into playing guitar when I saw him on television for the first time. And I think his appearance on Ed Sullivan's Show and Tommy Dorsey in that 1 month after he changed the world and basically propelled rock and roll into the mainstream of it. Before that, it was kind of an underground movement fighting the big bands and the Tony Bennett's and Frank Sinatra's and everything else. Elvis pushed it over. I contend that the American Army killed Elvis. When they drafted him, it was kind of the end. There was remember pictures of him shaving his head and giving him a Marine haircut and all that stuff. But then he put on the movie called G.I. Blues. And from this movie, G.I. Blues, this is on the soundtrack, written by, like I said, Bert Camper. And it's Elvis singing in a little bit of English, a little bit of German. Wooden Heart, 1961.
And you see, I love you. Please don't break my heart in two. That's the hard to do, cause I don't have a room in there.
J-Lo, and now we're going to get into CD. I just made that up. That's Celine Dion. Without a doubt, Canada's finest singer, Celine Dion, amazing voice. Probably one of the best singers in the world. Still going through her personal trials, but she still goes on and still singing and planning a tour, and her big residency in Vegas was the biggest success of all time. And here's Celine Dion, 2013, singing in Mandarin on the Chinese state TV as part of its New Year's Eve gala, welcoming in the Lunar New Year in 2013. And what's amazing about this is we're going to be featuring Celine in several songs on the show, and she sings perfectly in every language. Daily, apparently, she has a linguist traveling with her, because when she's kind of relaxed, she talks in her Quebecois kind of English, but they teach her how to pronounce English words, so she's singing properly and on stage. So the same thing when she's singing in German, Italian, Chinese, whatever. So here's Celine Dion, Chinese New Year's Eve 2013. This song is called Jasmine Flower, which is Modi Hua. And she's singing with the famous Chinese soprano, Song Suying. Celine. Now we're going to go back to Germany. His name was Johann Hosel, known as Hans Hosel, but his stage name was Falco, F-A-L-C-O. There's a great synth pop song sung in German, and everybody sang along with it. A lot of it was fanatic. Oh, that day, though, the commissars in town. 1981, Falco with Der Kommissar. Thank you. Falco was your commissar. We lost him in a car accident several years ago. But that song and that album, they reached 64 on the Billboard charts. He sold 20 million albums and 15 million singles with that song, Der Kommissar. And he was Austrian, by the way, so Austria is the biggest selling pop artist. That's a guy who I've known a long time. He has an incredible voice. He'd be Bill Elvis' shoes, and I always stop going to Vegas when I'm talking about Wayne Newton. He plays banjo, bass, guitar, piano, sings, dances, does everything. He plays about 10 or 11 instruments and plays them well. So you will recognize this song was on the radio by Wayne Newton. Then it was done by Ferris Bueller.